So, Peter Tchir, we're going to hear from Congress, I guess, about these various loopholes and questions left open. But I thought we were going to go to a territorial tax system. This statement in the outline tends to undermine that.
Yeah, I think they had grand plans earlier this year, and now they're having to face the reality. It's going to be much more of a simplistic tax cut with a few ways to bring some money back to offset those immediate tax cuts. So it's not that exciting of a plan in the end. It's interesting, but it's not the whole-scale reform at one time they were talking about.
I'm a bit curious, Peter. What do you think is more likely? What's got broader support? Is it this multinational tax? Is it a broad corporate tax change? Are they likely to get both? Or is it kind of a one or the other question?
It does seem to me, and from what I'm hearing, that we're headed towards this sort of 20% tax rate with this repatriation and some form of offshore tax to prevent the inversions. There seems to be relatively broad-based support for that. I think the market has to start adapting. The one thing, start looking at markets really rallied on the tax reform, and if you start digging in the details, a lot of companies are paying sub 20% effective tax rates, maybe even below 15%. I'd be a little bit nervous investing in those companies because you could see tax rates go up. And the other big part to me is the repatriation. There's this view somehow that the repatriated money is going to somehow either get spent in the economy or sent back to, you know, shareholders. The reality is a lot of the companies that have big offshore have been borrowing money for the past 3-4 years. So you may have $50 billion offshore, but you now have $50 billion of debt. I think a lot of that is going to be used to consolidate the debt, slow down the debt. It is not going to be a big windfall for shareholders.